Hey, mister.
Oh.
Miss.
Howdy, mister.
Did, you lose a tiger?
Yeah, you found one?
Nah, I found your caravan down the way. Margaret said that you might need a hand.
Oh, you weren't wrong. That tiger's missing. I sent our best lion out to find him, and, now he's missing too. It is a right old predicament.
Your lion from, Timbuktu, weren't he? Oh,
from Valentine, I think. He might be more of a kind of dog than a lion, but in a certain light, a feller could never tell.
Of course. Which way'd he go?
Into them shrubs over there.
Okay. Why don't you hop up on the wagon and I'll see if I can find his track.
Okay. That first set of shrubs, that's where I lost sight of it.
I got it. Paw prints. Looks like blood to me.
What's this?
Found your dog!
Ex-dog, ex-lion.
Hey, boy! Oh, where's the rest of them?
I think a cougar took them.
That'd be Stripey. And I always thought they got along.
Your tiger is a wild cat?
Uh-huh.
What else? You still need it back?
Oh, yes, sir. She's our star attraction.
Well, let's hope it wants the other half of its dinner.
The other half? Really?
I'm gonna put him in your wagon. You find somewhere to hide.
Oh. Well, behind that log, then.
Okay. Grubs up. Stay down. She won't be too far away.
Come quick! I went out to find a tiger.
Cougar, you mean?
And I end up losing a lion.
Yeah, dog.
Ain't having any luck.
Well, if that's what you're dealing with, you didn't have any luck to begin with. Cougars and dogs.
Hey, it ain't what you got in this life. It's what you make of it.
Well, that's very wise of you. Especially when you're lacking zebras and tigers. Hey, keep your head down. It's coming.
Look, I really don't think she'll eat the dog. Like I said, they was friends.
Shut it.
Oh, well, I guess she's real hungry.
She's feral. I'm locking her in. Thank you.
I guess she's real hungry.
She's feral. I'm locking her in.
Oh, I guess she's real hungry.
She's feral. I'm locking her in. Let's go.
We got her! Okay. Drive, will you? And I'll keep an eye on her.
Sure thing.
Let's get her back to Mr. Margaret. She's still eating. I would have thought, since they was close and all.
Well, wild creatures turn on each other. Seeming friendly one minute, dinner the next. This comes easy. I mean, I should know. I've run with a few of them myself.
Is that right?
No, not really. Hey, I realize I ain't properly introduced myself.
Sally Nash.
Arthur Morgan.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Tell me, Miss Nash, how you end up in this racket?
I guess it's always been my inclination, you know? Wild beasts and the like. I met Mr. Margaret, we got to talking, and you can probably tell, in this field, he's the ace of spades.
He's a card, all right.
It's my modest hope, one day, to be the world's second bravest woman animal wrangler.
I'd say you got that sewn up and then some.
You think? I hope so. Top five, at least. Depends on how many more fellers throw their hat in the ring.
Maybe one of these days, the best female for the job will actually be a female.
Oh, I don't know if that'll ever happen. We lost the main road around here when the dust was up. Be careful or you might get wrecked too.
Okay. You know the only thing to do in a dust storm is wait it out?
Mr. Margaret's a lot of things, but best female navigator ain't one of them.
Imagine you're right about that.
We was tearing around here, looking for any kind of landmark, when over we go. Whole caravan toppled. Found each other and some shelter, but when the wind died down, the animals was gone.
And now they're back. Some of them, at least.
Thanks to you.
You would have managed it yourself. I just helped you along.
If you ever want to get in the sideshow business, I'm sure there'd be a place for a fellow like you.
I'll leave the professional theatrics to better win.
Aha! I see you found each other.
Sure did, Mr. Margaret.
Jolly good! Jolly good!
You know, tarring and feathering a donkey is one thing.
I beg your pardon? It's grease paint. Makeup.
But playing dolls dressed up with a wild animal, you're gonna want to be a lot more careful.
Strappy ate King, Mr. Margaret. I saw her do it.
I always thought they got along.
Oh, she liked him just fine. She licked her chops and asked for seconds. Hey, speaking of which, you got any more word on that runaway lion, or are you going to pay me for these misfits?
Look, I'm well aware that we're not Royal Command performance material. Daddy, you were right, goddamn you! But a cow barn in Rhodes is hardly Drury Bloody Lane.
You got any word on the lion?
Yes, yes, I've got word on the lion. Shit is the word. Someone saw him near Emerald Ranch. As you know, we're lately very short on lions. So, I'd be very grateful. All kinds of grateful.
There's only one kind of grateful I care about.
So long, mister.
Be a dear and fix me a gin.
driver Peter.
What's the ruckus, boys?
Get back! We got a cursed creature in. He is a mule as mean as a hellcat.
It looks like a lion to me.
That's a dog in there.
A dog?
Now, you'll excuse me. Step aside.
What?
I said step aside. Yeah, boy.
Didn't look like no dog.
Come here, boy. Let's go.
Whoever owned that beast got some answering to do.
I've never seen one of those before, and I hope I don't again.
You're all right, girl.
Odysseus returns. Sally, get the cages ready.
Yes, sir, Mr. Market, right away.
The man-eating lion. You didn't think that it might be useful for me to know that this time the animal was actually real, you moron?
Steady on. I clearly stated that we were looking
for... You haven't clearly stated anything in all the time I've known you. That could have been a goose for all I know.
A goose? We'll hardly get them to their feet for the curtain call. Bring on the king of the beasts, on the other hand, and they feel the roar. And they, well, look about as surprised as you do. What have you done with him, if you don't mind me asking?
I killed him. He's dead.
Bloody hell! This is rum, old boy.
Well, it was him or me. Now, pay me.
Yes, of course, of course. I have just the thing. And what a treasure it is! You're a lucky man, sir. Very lucky man. From the mines of El Dorado, as green as the rainforest, as clear as the Amazon, and as dear as all the gold in the Andes. One man's labor is but a trifle compared to this jewel's true value. Wait! I shouldn't. What would Daddy say?
Your daddy ain't here, and we had a deal.
Yes, of course. A promise is a promise. Sally, get the wagons moving.
Ain't we waiting for the lion?
He's in the great hunting ground in the sky. Good day, sir, and thank you. But we really must be getting along.
Yeah, I won't keep you. So long.
Hi-yah! So long, Mr. Morgan. Next time you see me, I'll be topping the bill, I promise. Or at least I'll be on the bill.
Oh, any good time, my dear.
Let's go, girl. Giddy up.
Cargo you bringing through here?
Easy there.
Move on through, boy.
I'm trying to get these supplies to the federal building. It's on the knee.
They don't respect your outfit.
Yep.
What should we play at your funeral?
Jesus Christ. Glad I weren't the target. Thank you for your help.
sheriff's orders. You wanted me to have a word with some folk on the property. I'm recently deputized, you see.
Deputized? And I suppose Lee was drunk when he did it? Look, you can come in, but you ain't talking with me.
Obliged. Hey, I was hoping you'd talk a moment. I'm a student of the history of the region, and,
I ain't the one to speak to. Try Master Bo. Think he's down there by the wood store. Boy's got all the time in the world.
I'll see you at the sheriff's office.
Excuse me, friend.
We friends?
Not yet, but he is hoping.
I guess.
We don't get a lot of traveling men here, and suddenly there's a whole phalanx of mysterious but strangely helpful Yankees about the place.
Is there?
What are you doing here?
I was just looking for work.
Well, looking for something. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
I got a secret of my own.
Are you secretly normal?
Excuse me?
Never mind.
The thing is, I don't care if you kill the whole lot of us and the Braithwaites.
I don't want to kill anyone.
I love her, you know.
Love who?
Penelope. But it's impossible.
Well, love tends to be complicated.
She's a Braithwaite. I'm Bo Gray, son of Tavish Gray, nephew of Lee Gray, the sheriff, grandson of old Murdo Gray. We Greys have been loyal to the state and murderous to the Braithwaites for so long now, no one can even quite explain why. Beyond blind loyalty and stupidity, I'm supposed to be loyal to some nonsense while she's amazing. She's like a woman from the future. She's like tomorrow, if tomorrow turns out fine.
Well, I'm sorry for your predicament.
Would you help?
I don't want to get involved. Gang feuds. Seems unseemly.
I'll pay. I've got money. We Greys, we've always got money. No brains, mind, but money.
Well, in that case...
I know she loves to sit out in the gazebo on the edge of the Braithwaite property. Take her this letter and this bracelet, please.
Oh, look out for their guards. They're worse with strangers than ours are.
Hey, mister.
Morning.
Thank you.
Penelope Braithwaite?
Well, yes, I am.
I've got a letter for you.
Oh.
And a gift.
A letter and a gift. Well, we don't even know each other.
Well, it's not from me. It's from,
From Bo. Oh, he is so...
strange?
Yes, he's a little strange, but also so human. The rest of our families are stuck in the Dark Ages, or... well, I don't know, cave people, perhaps. Bo's different. But if they find out, they'll kill him and send me to live someplace awful, like Ohio. Have you ever been to Ohio, sir?
No.
Well, neither have I, but my uncle has a factory there. He was sort of the black sheep on account of having left. But now they tolerate him because he's a vicious snob. Families are... there's something else. You got a family, sir?
No, not really.
Well, they tolerate him because of the money. But me, with my ideas above my station, they can't stand.
That sounds pretty complicated. I don't know quite what to say.
Well, nothing to say, except I hope they all rot. I don't. Well, maybe a bit. But here, if you see Bo again, will you give this to him?
Sure.
Thank you.
girl.
Hey, you! Hell you think you're doing here?
Calm down, will you?
Got a good haul there, girl. It's me!
Welcome back.
Get the horse out of here!
Okay, okay, keep your hair off.
Food or some money, Arthur.
I know.
Haven't received anything from you in a while, Mr. Morgan.
Yeah, I will.
All right, let's see what we got. If only it was in better condition. Let's see what we can get for it. This is going in the pot.
Good job, Mr. Morgan.
Save you. Save everybody. You know me. I'll go back to Blackwater and get the money. Meet you all someplace and we'll be home free. That's it. Just think about it. That's all I'm saying. The way I see it, we gotta try.
No rest for us idiots, eh, Morgan?
Thank you.
Arthur breaks them, we fix them. That seems to be the way.
Remember, lift from the knees.
He's still here.
If it ain't Sheriff Morgan.